Hello everyone, welcome to yet another video tutorial of WebEpic channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about how to configure auto feed update. And obviously we'll be using CTX feed, a WooCommerce product feed generator plugin as usual. So without further ado, let's start the video. So right now I'm at my WordPress website. Let me go to CTX feed. And in CTX feed, you will see this interval. What this interval will do, it will give you some options to select your update interval. You can make it from 1 hour to 6 hours, 12 hours, 24 hours, or even if a week if you want to. And if you make it very low, like 1 hour, it will update your feed after each and every hour you are in the site. But what that will do, that will actually slow your website down. It will make your website slower and it will lag. So you might want to make your update interval in between 24 hours and 1 hour. So I'm gonna go with 12 hours in this case. And you can turn your auto update on and off by switching this button. As a preset of CTX feed, the auto update is always stayed turned on. But if you want, you can switch it off just by clicking onto it. You can switch this button off and you can also turn it on at your will. For example, if you are creating a test feed, you might want to turn your auto update off because it's a test feed and you don't need to update your feed on a regular interval. But if you are working with a feed that you need as your working purpose, then definitely you might want to turn auto update on. Another thing to ensure your auto feed update is working properly, you can go to status, and in status, if you look at WP cron, it will say okay. If your auto update is working properly, it will say okay, and if it says something else other than okay, then your auto update is not working. Another thing is our CTX feed plugin works in a batch while generating the feed. So this product per batch selects the amount of product it processes in every batch. So for example, if you have 1,000 product in your site, it will process 200 product per batch. So it will take 5 time to execute all of your product to update in the feed. Also, there is another vital point, which is PHP time limit. Here it says the time limit is 3000. But if your PHP time limit is lower, for example, if it's 60 or 30 or very low, then your auto update might fail. So you must make sure your PHP time limit is higher. Just like I'm showing here, 3000 is a pretty good time limit. So you might want to make sure your PHP time limit is higher in this case. And by the way, this feature of auto feed update is available for free version of CTX feed as well as the pro version of CTX feed. So you can get the feature anyway. That's all for today's video. Thank you for watching.